Opportunity to recognize our sophomores that will be graduating tonight here at NMJC. It's been a great group. We are in debt to all of their commitment and effort that they put into this program, building this culture with Coach Robbins and Coach Felix, and you will always be appreciated. In departing, Coach Robbins has to say, as a part of the NMJC baseball program, this group is responsible for 82 wins, and a conference championship. There are four All-Western Junior College Athletic Conference selections from 22, three All-Region 5 selections from 22, a Conference Pitcher of the Year. There is a 2023 NMJC Male Academic Athlete of the Year, and four NJCAA All-American team members, and a combined 3.4 GPA to date. 11 of them are already signed to move on to the four-year level with more to come. What they have brought to our program is invaluable and appreciated too much to put into words. Thank you from Coach Felix and Coach Robbins. And now we'll introduce these young men in numerical order. First, number two, J.D. Moreno. 16, David Hankins. And number 17, Mark Henning. And number 18, Robert Bonilla. Number 21, Josh Pearl. And number 25, Jaron Lewis. Number 26, Colton Coots. Number 28, Max Swenson. Number 30, Oscar Tucci. And number 32, Luis Gonzalez. And number 34, Paul Coppinger. Number 35, E.J. Miramontes. Number 37, Logan McNeil. And last but not least, number 42, Carlos Anziani. Gentlemen, if you could move to home plate and let's organize ourselves for a group picture for Coach Fay. Give them a round of applause. They've done a great job. Parents, while they're getting this picture in order, give us until tomorrow, and Coach Fay will have all these pictures up on the website for you to download at your disposal. Thank you again, gentlemen. All right, we'll let the coaches have their meeting at home plate, and then we'll do the national anthem and introduce the starting lineup for the T-Birds. Thank you again for being here.
time when we leave. All this now?
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen. At this time, if you would please rise, we're going to ask that our gentlemen remove their caps for the playing of the national anthem. Dylan Hasso. Batting second, playing shortstop, number 11, Brent Iredale. Batting third, playing second base, number 3, Aaron Lugo. Batting fourth, playing left field, number 4, Eric Bonilla. Batting fifth, playing first base, number 17, Mark Henning. Batting sixth, playing first base, number 32, Luis Gonzalez. Batting seventh, playing right field, number 21, Josh Pearl. Batting eighth, and playing center field, number 2, J.D. Moreno. And batting ninth today, number 10, the catcher, Lorenzo Morisi. And on the mound this afternoon in game 1 for the Keepers, number 19, Landon New York. The Keepers are coached by head coach Michael Robbins, and he is assisted by Lario Felix.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. We are here for the final two games of the broadcast season anyways. I'm Dusty Windham. Thanks for being here. T-Birds have a chance to clinch with a victory today over Midland College. And we'll have two games today. The first one scheduled for 7 innings. Second game scheduled for 9. Of course, T-Birds have a 3-game lead over the Chaparrals in the conference standings. And well, this is what it all boils down to, the final series of the season, and here we are to try to win another WJCAC championship for the New Mexico Junior College Thunderbirds. Again, I'm Dusty Windham. Thanks for being here with us. We're at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field here on the campus of New Mexico Junior College here in Hobbs, New Mexico. And before we get started, just want to say I have had a blast with you guys all season long, and hopefully you guys have had just as much fun listening or watching from wherever you are. It's always a privilege for me to do this, and this team really has a special place to me, and I'm excited to see what the rest of the season brings. Although these are my last two broadcasts, I will be continuing to follow this team. Head coach Mike Robbins is assisted by Laurel Felix, and man, what a coaching staff it is here at New Mexico Junior College. T-Birds have been solid all season long. I mean, they started with tough competition early on in the year and ended up benefiting from that throughout this conference schedule. So Landon York toes the mound for the T-Birds here, dressed in red out in the field, ready for the top half of the first inning. And this will be the shortstop, Cody Grebeck out of Midland, Texas, of course, a hometown kid, went to Midland Christian. And the first pitch from York swung on and missed for a strike. So T-Birds off to a good start with Landon York on the hill. The 0-1 on its way. Oof, just off the plate. And a ball called. Much to the dismay of the fans in the stands. You could hear a little bit of the collective groan there after the call. So here comes the 1-1 on its way. A swing and a miss again, and it's one ball, two strikes here to Grebeck. See here, I'm getting into the stats, and we'll get those going as well as we get going. We had a bit of a delay for me as sophomore recognition day was here. Oh, my goodness. 2-2 after the call there. And crowd again showing their displeasure with the call. So York to deliver the 2-2 brings it straight in. This one has popped up out towards center field. J.D. Moreno under it. And he'll make the play out in center. One away here in the top half of the first. So that'll bring up the left fielder, number one, Jake Martinez here for the Shaps. And we'll see what he does here. York into the windup, delivers the pitch, a called strike on the outside part of the plate, and it is now 0-1. If you guys haven't been out to see this team this season, well, you don't know what you're missing. Good group out here and a very solid baseball team. Coach well, they play well, good kids. Just a lot of fun to be around these guys this season. First pitch was fouled off for, or second pitch was fouled off for a strike. It's 0-2, excuse me. Way up high with that one, and not chasing was Martinez. So it's a 1-2 count for York as he steps back up on the rubber. Swing and a miss that time, and York's got his first K of the day. Think what a hectic day this will be for these kids that are graduating after game two today. Graduation here at New Mexico Junior College. And that'll bring up Rhett Clark. So we'll see what Clark does here. First pitch, a called ball, close, but not close enough in the eyes of the home plate umpire. And that one also called a ball. It's 2-0. Must have missed outside that time. As York gets ready to go again into the windup, and here comes the pitch. It is fouled back to the screen, and that'll make it a 2-1 count. Let's see, Rhett Clark here from Midland as well, another local product. Jake Martinez out of Corpus Christi. And with two away, York misses with the 2-1. So a 3-1 count, pitch on its way, and it's hit hard and high. Deep towards left center, Moreno and Bionilla both calling for it, and they will collide. But the play is made out there, and it looks like Moreno's the one that came away with the ball. So three up, three down for the Midland College Shaps as we head to the bottom half of inning number one, scoreless, right here at NMJC. We'll be right back. All right, back again here at New Mexico Junior College, right Birmingham Thunderbird Field, home of your New Mexico Junior College Thunderbirds, hoping to clinch the conference championship here against Midland College, a team who they have a 3-game lead on to start this season, or to end this season, actually, and do in conference standings. It's just been close, and T-Birds gave one away last week. Could have made it a little bit easier, but this one is across for a strike from the pitcher Boudreaux. Tyler Boudreaux out of Sylvan Lake, Alberta, in Canada, delivers the 0-1, and it's lined out in the right field for a single from our good friend Dylan Hasso. Hasso in the top three or four in the country in home runs. I think he was sixth as we ended last week, actually, as Brent Iredale will head to the plate after the Hasso single gets things started. So Iredale now, young man from Australia, playing shortstop, will tap this one back foul to the screen. And it's an 0-1 count. So Hasso over at first, throw on the mound. Pickoff attempt that time, just throw over to first. Back safely is Hasso. And we'll see what Boudreaux does. The 0-1 across for a called strike that Iredale disagreed with. Thought it was up and outside a little bit, but the umpire made the call, and it's 0-2. Boudreaux looks in, nods his head, looks over at first, and comes to the plate. He'll bean Iredale, and Iredale will get first base after getting hit by the pitch. And that'll put Hasso at second. Runners at first and second for Aaron Lugo. The second baseman, young man from Parral, Chihuahua, Mexico, same as Dylan Hasso, will step into the box. One of the sophomores we were talking about a moment ago, seeing recognition before the game. And somebody the T-Birds have relied on heavily over the past couple of seasons. So nobody out, bottom half of the first inning in a scoreless game. Aaron Lugo at the plate with runners at first and second. Lugo takes the first pitch up high for a ball. And now he gets ready to go again. Boudreaux will nod to the catcher. And now the stretch, he'll come to the plate. Outside for another ball, it's 2-0. And we'll get ready to go again. A little slow going, very deliberate, and throwing a strike. That time is Boudreaux. 2-1 count here to Aaron Lugo. On deck, it'll be Eric Bayania playing out in left field for the T-Birds today. And Boudreaux ready to come to the dish again. Timeout call. And that's going to be a 3-1 count as the pitch count, the clock ran out on Boudreaux, and he'll have to try it again. So 3-1 now the count. And it'll be a ball four call. So a walk leaves the bases loaded here for the T-Birds with nobody out in the cleanup man. Eric Goodbye-ania coming up.
Attention, please. Now batting the left fielder, number four, Eric
Bayania. So Bayania will be heading to the plate here with the bases loaded, and first pitch from Boudreaux is across for a strike. So Bionia will look at the 0-1 coming here with the bases loaded. And a chance to start this game off good for the T-Birds. He grounds it over to short. There's a throw over to third. That will retire Iredale, but not before Hasso scores. And that will give the T-Birds a 1-0 lead. So really, fixing my book as the first pitch comes in for a ball from Boudreaux, and Mark Henning will be the hitter. First lefty of the day to face Boudreaux. Now a ball hit right back at Boudreaux. Low throw. The shortstop will grab it just in time. I think they're going to call him safe at first as Henning will reach. But that'll put runners on the corners here now with two down. And so Luis Gonzalez, yet another sophomore, will be here. And Gonzalez will foul that one off. This one is a ball called inside a bit that time. And now a throw over to keep Henning honest over at first with Lugo at third and a 1-1 count. This one up and in, and it'll be a 2-1 count now to Gonzalez. Luis playing over at first today with Lorenzo Morassi behind the dish. Josh Pearl on deck. Another big Aussie playing out in right. This one way outside for a third ball, and it's 3-1. T-Birds did push one across earlier here in this first inning. And they're hoping to get at least one more here. With Gonzalez at the plate. Swings a good bat. See what Boudreaux comes up with. He'll throw over to first. And Henning dives back in safely. And we're ready for the 3-1. Again, two down and runners on the corners here in the first. That one's going to be a walk. Ball four issued there to Gonzalez. We'll load the bases once again. And now, coming to the plate, will be Pearl. Josh Pearl, the right fielder here, with his first chance to take a look at Boudreaux here.
Right fielder, number 21, Josh Pearl.
So, Pearl steps in, and that one's a called strike right down the middle this time from Boudreaux, and it's 0-1. Already 19 pitches thrown this inning. As T-Birds have gotten quite a ways down in the lineup, J.D. Moreno up to bat after this. Second pitch called a strike. I think Pearl thought that one was high, and it's 0-2. Still shaking his head as he steps back in the box. Boudreaux looking for his first strikeout of the day. Went blowing out again today, just mostly towards straightaway center. Could be a fun afternoon. That one off the plate outside, and it'll be a ball called and a 1-2 count. Lugo's over at third with Henning at second and Gonzalez at first, awaiting their chance to move. Lugo fakes going. This one bounces and squirts away from the catcher for just a moment. He's able to get that back. I believe that's Hudson Parker behind the dish, number 8. And we've got a 2-2 count. Still got two down here. But the base is loaded for the T-Birds. A swing and a foul off the other way for Pearl. So we'll get a chance to do it again. 2-2. Swung on and missed. Pearl goes down on strikes, and that'll be the first strikeout of the day for Boudreaux. But the T-Birds do get one in the bottom half of the first, and they lead it 1-0 heading to inning number 2. We'll be right back. And we are back again here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field, ready for inning number 2. The T-Birds looking to clinch the WJCAC title as it is Landon York on the mound, and I don't know if it's Xavier or Javier Melendez, but Melendez from Odessa, Texas. Just down the road a spell there from Midland. First pitch from York to Melendez is a strike. 0-1 count here. A 1-0 lead for the T-Birds. A couple of walks and a hit batsman, as that one will just miss the spot the umpire was looking for anyways, and it's 1-1. T-Birds have a 3-game lead on Midland. This is 1-4 this weekend against the Shaps. And a win here would put away the conference title. The T-Birds hoping to clinch here at home today. And a 2-1 count now after the third pitch misses here from Yorick. Now the 2-1 swung on and missed, and it's a 2-2 count. And the 2-2, oof, just off the plate. Tough call. I think that's the same pitch Josh Pearl was shaking his head at earlier, but to no avail. Did not help out for Pearl. And this time called a ball against the Shaps, or against the T-Birds, if you will. That ball was hit a long way foul. Thank goodness for the T-Birds, because it cleared the right field wall by about 3 feet. And we'll get another 3-2 pitch coming here. Melendez on the year is hitting .449. He's got, 6 homers, 45 RBIs, struck out 32 times, walked 28 now, as that pitch misses from Landon York.
Now batting catcher number 8, Hudson Parker.
And that'll be the first base runner allowed so far by the T-Birds. And it'll be Hudson Parker, number 8, coming to the plate now. So one on, nobody out here in the top half of inning number two. And the first pitch to Parker is a strike from Landon York. 0-1 count. See what Parker's done on the year here. As it looks like he's hitting 367. Good pickoff move. Thought he had him over at first. Looks like the tag was a little bit laid up on the thigh, but good move that time from York. So Parker, 8 homers, 32 RBI on the year to go along with that 367 average. Second pitch misses. And it's 1-1. And so here comes the 1-1 on its way from York. It's hit hard out towards center and carrying in the wind. We'll let it carry out of the park. It's 2-1 Midland just that quick. Hudson Parker gives the Shaps a lead and hope for the conference championship crown here. Straightaway center, and again the wind is blowing out. I don't think that really factored into that ball. And it's a 2-1 game, Midland leading. So this will bring up Frainer Chavez with a lead and nobody out. The base is clear. First pitch up and outside that time. Mauricio will grab it. And it'll be a 1-0 count from Landon York. So Chavez hitting 350 with, let's look, 3 homers, 39 RBI. Second pitch misses as well. And it's a 2-0 count. Good pitch. Now the crowd really getting upset, and coming out is going to be Mike Robbins to speak with Landon York after, I don't know how that one missed, but it did according to the home plate umpire. The crowd here really getting on old Blue from behind the dish and in the stands here. That, I don't know. Strike zone's kind of been everywhere, and we're just now in the top half of the second inning. T-Birds have been rung up on a couple of these pitches that are being called balls the other way. Not that that's going to factor into it. Both teams have to deal with umpires. Both teams have to deal with strike zone that's not consistent. So it's not anything unusual here. Now the umpire is out to talk with Mike Robbins, and Mike's probably going to ask the question, where the heck were those pitches at to be called balls? So we'll keep going here. Let's say a little bit more about Frainer Chavez. Chavez is a young man from Little Elm, Texas. Listing at 5'8", a sophomore as well. And a 3-0 count as we get back to the action here. Mike Robbins not happy as he comes back to the dugout. And there's a strike called there on the taking the whole way. He feigned a bunt, did Chavez. On deck for Midland will be number 22, as that one will miss as well. York looks towards the dugout after the walk. And that will bring up Justin Rumfield. Rumfield from Denton, Texas, a freshman. And we'll see what he has here. So York will look to deal to Rumfield here. And the first pitch will miss for yet another ball called. And that one up and in. I will agree with that one being the ball. That's for sure. 2-0 count now here to Rumfield. As York trying to regain composure. Gave up the 2-run shot earlier in the inning, then in 5 pitches walked Chavez, and here he is against Rumfield. Swing and miss that time for a strike, and it's 2-1. Heading out to the bullpen is going to be number 34, and of course that's Paul Coppinger, the big man. Also looks like E.J. Miramontes is heading out there too. He may just be backing some stuff up as I only see one catcher heading that way. York to the plate. It's hit hard out towards left, right at Bayania. Eric will make the play and get the ball back in here as Lugo will take it on a hop. So an out recorded here as coming to the plate will be, double checking, number 25 here, and that is Michael Widener. Widener also out of Midland, the sophomore. And we'll see what Widener does. York's first pitch, just a bit high perhaps, and it's a 1-0 count. Get this book straightened out here as I keep going, get Widener in there correctly. Let's see where we go. As we've got a 2-0 count here with one away and a runner at first for the T-Birds. And that one will miss as well. It's 3-0. So my app kind of stopped here with the book. A steal of the bag as the throw hits the player in the back. And Rumfield will stay over as, or not Rumfield, excuse me, that was a Chavez over at second. Sure did freeze, I'll have to open it back up. We got a 3-1 count here though. Dancing is Chavez over at second. York not worried about it, comes to the plate. Strike called and it's a full count. So, payoff pitch coming with a runner at second and just one away. T-Birds trail at 2-1 here in the top half of the second, and they are in the field. At the plate, the Midland College Chaps, and Widener pops one up. Shallow right field, Pearl looking for it, finds it, and he will be able to get a hold of it. Chavez will tag and go to third, but there are two away.
With two outs, that brings up the center fielder, number 10, Kyle Lewis.
So let's see if we can get everything going. It completely crashed there. So two down, as coming to the plate will be Kyle Lewis, a 5'9 freshman out of Lubbock. And this one will be a ball called again. One pitch on its way, up and in just a bit, and it's going to be a 2-0 count. And so, York delivers the 2-0 foul back to the center block, and then Moresi, with the eyes in the back of his head, picks that one up. Let's see here. We'll get York back in the book. The 2-1, a called strike as he bends that one across, and it's evened out at 2-2. Two down and a runner at third. And two runs already across in the inning due to a two-run shot hit by Hudson Parker. This one up high this time. See if I can get to Moresi in the book again. having a good year behind the dish and other places as well. He's hit the ball well this season and definitely taken a beating back behind the plate. There he is. That one a called strike three. Unbelievable to Kyle Lewis as he'll shake his head, throw his bat, and then take his helmet off. And the T-Birds are out of the inning. Landon York with a couple of Ks there. So, after 1.5, 2-1, Midland College leads it. And the T-Birds will be looking to tie it up or take the lead here in the bottom half of the inning when we come back in just a moment. All right, we are back again here at NMJC. T-Birds leading it, or trailing it 2-1. They were leading after 1-0. Here we are in the bottom half of inning number two. And first pitch swinging is J.D. Moreno, the center fielder and sophomore, will get a base hit to start off his day here at the plate. And that'll bring up Lorenzo Maresi. So, first pitch from Boudreaux, a called strike to the left-handed hitting Maresi. And now this ball's hit high and deep. It's going to get over the wall. Lorenzo Maresi has given the T-Birds the lead here. Right back again. Bottom half of the second inning. 3-2, New Mexico Junior College. Big bomb by Lorenzo there. And that's huge for the T-Birds. And they're up. They're fired up for this one. Landon York won the first out to congratulate his teammates as we get to have the celebration here. And the T-Birds now will send Dylan Hasso to the plate. 3-2 New Mexico Junior College. Let me see if I can get back into the book here. Big shot for Maresi. Now comes one of your top 10 home run hitters in the country with Dylan Hasso up. First pitch is across for a strike from Boudreaux. And he'll get hit with a pitch. Second hit batsman as he kind of looks over at him. And then the pitcher kind of walked towards him a little bit like he wanted some of that. I don't think Boudreaux wants to mess with Hasso that much. So Hasso will head over to first. And with nobody out and a runner at first, that will bring up Brent Iredale. Iredale was retired at third base his first time up. And the first pitch there, a ball to Iredale. Boudreaux looking over towards Hasso at first. And the first pitch is going to be fouled or the second pitch is fouled back, but the first swing, by the way, of Iredell. So 1-1. And Boudreau will look in, try to get a grip on it that he likes. Comes to the dish, and it'll be outside for a ball and a 2-1 count. So already home runs hit in this game. We're just in the second inning, each team with one. And this one's going to be fouled off down the third base side. And that'll even out the count at 2-2. We're still going through the lineup, getting our new book ready. But a 2-2 count over at first. Dylan Hossel, 4-yard Thunderbirds. And a throw over to first. A little late to get him. And we'll take a look at it here. Boudreau will stare in. And today's one of those days you can see a lot of offense here at the ballpark. Swing and a miss by Iredell there. We'll retire him on strikes. And that will bring up Aaron Lugo, the second baseman.
Now batting with one out.
So Lugo will step in here with one away and a runner at first and a 3-2 lead. Lugo right over the shortstop into left field for a base knock. And now there's going to be two on and one away for Eric Bionilla. So Bionilla will step in here with another chance to hit. And get back to my lineup one more time. And this one will miss outside for a ball from Boudreau. And it's going to be a 1-0 count. Again, you got Lugo at first, Hasso at second, and one away. Mark Henning waiting on deck, and Eric Bionilla in the box. Swing, and a bit of a tip that time. Yeah, it says it will tip the bat. I thought it did. And it's a 1-1 count. Let me look at this lineup again. Did I have it right? I did. Okay. This one, third hit batsman by the pitcher Boudreau in just an inning and a third. So T-Birds have the bases loaded yet again, one away here. And that will bring up Mark Henning for the T-Birds. Reached his first time up.
First baseman number 17, Mark Henning.
And let's see here. That one will be a called strike for an 0-1 count. Still working on this lineup again after the app crashed. That's why I like an old-fashioned book. 0-1 count and the pitch on its way. And that'll miss. Ball two, 2-0 count. And double checking the lineup here. The 1-1 on its way. Swing and a miss that time by Henning, and it's 1-2. And the 1-2 swung on and missed, another strikeout here. A couple in the inning now for Boudreau, and that'll bring up Luis Gonzalez with two down and the bases loaded. 3-2 game. T-Birds taking the lead on the two-run Lorenzo Maresi home run just a few moments ago. And Luis steps back up. And this ball is popped up out into right, and now coming up to make the play is Widener. And he will do so. So the T-Birds leave them loaded, but do get two in the inning. They lead it 3-2 heading to the third. We'll be right back. So we're back again, and it's Cody Grubick to start again. The inning, the leadoff man and shortstop for the Shabs will look at the first pitch from York for a ball called. And after the second pitch thrown, is called a ball as well. York back to the wristband, now to the plate. Strike called this time to Grubick in the count now, 2-1. This one's going to be fouled back, and it'll be a 2-2 count. This one will be a called ball to fill up the count now. And the leadoff man for this top half of the third inning for Midland. We'll see a payoff pitch here from York. Strike three called. York popped up out on the mound. The T-Birds will go around the horn, and that'll do it.
Number 1, Jake Martinez.
Let me get in here. Jake Martinez now will come up. And first pitch swinging. He'll pop it out into right. Looks like it'll take a bounce. It will get to Pearl, who will take it on the second bounce, actually, and get it in. A single there for Jake Martinez. So a runner on and one away now here. As Rhett Clark, the third baseman, will come up. And we'll see what happens here. Runner on first, one away, and that one just off the plate for a ball, and it's a 1-0 count. And that one will be called a ball off the plate as well. end. Now he throw over to first. Pretty quick move there by York. Now this ball fouled off down the third base side, barehanded by the third base coach and tossed into the T-Bird dugout. And we'll try it again. Top half, third inning here. And just getting going, really, on the day. Game one of two, four on the weekend, but two here at home today, two in Midland tomorrow. That pitch called a strike, and it's 2-2. So, Brett Clark looking for a hit here. And that one tipped, and he'll stay alive. Will Clark. 2-2 still to count, and with a runner at first and one away, T-Birds lead it 3-2 on the strength of a two-run shot by Lorenzo Moresi in the bottom half of inning number two there. Now this one's going to be fouled off and spoiled again. Now an attempted steal there. The throw in time, and they'll get the runner at second. As he is tagged out, great throw by Moresi. The tag put down out at second base. And now 3-2 count with two outs and nobody on as Martinez will head back to the dugout. Clark now with a chance. And here we go. York back on the bump again. And this one's going to be fouled down the third base side this time, and we'll do it again. And we'll check it out one more time. This one fouled off again. A lot of pitches thrown here in the AB by York, but hanging tough so far has been Rhett Clark. And another one fouled off. This, the never-ending AB here. It's a really good at-bat for Clark. Another 3-2 on its way. It looked like he held up. He did not offer, and that will be a walk issued. So a runner on and two down now. And that's going to be the first baseman. And that's going to be Melendez coming back to the plate. And so York will start off this one with a strike swinging to Melendez. So an 0-1 count. Again, we're in the top half of inning number three of a crucial series, if you will. Chance for the T-Birds to clinch the conference with a win today in either of the games. Midland, three games back of the T-Birds and the Wagjack standings. And the 1-1. A called ball. The crowd here wanted the strike. Did not get it that time.
Come on.
And the runner goes, gets there that time to throw on a hop to Lugo, but successfully swiping a base. And the 3-1, a called strike, much to the dismay of Melendez, who thought it was outside, was ready to take his base, and we'll see another full count here, and another pitch from Landon Yorick. So we'll go again. App just keeps crashing, so we'll not keep a book myself. And there's the 3-2. It's just kind of fisted over towards second. Going to be a tough throw. Gonzalez could not hang on to it. Tough play for Lugo as he's running in and bounced the throw over to Luis at first and safely on the bag this time. Is Melendez. So it'll be Hudson Parker, the gentleman who hit the two-run shot off of Landon Yorick here in the second inning. Back to the plate with two on. Runners on the corners and two outs here in the third. First pitch from Yorick is a strike to Parker. Yorick will look over towards first. Now back to the plate, an 0-1 pitch coming here. And swung on, tipped into the mitt of Lorenzo Maresi, and it's 0-2. Parker with that home run in the second has his ninth of the year and 34 runs batted in. Called ball that time. It'll run the count to a ball and two strikes here. Just off the plate, maybe a bit high. As Yorick will look over towards first again. Again, runners at first and third and two outs here in a 3-2 game. T-Birds lead it. And Parker's got this one down in left field, and it actually clears the wall. His second home run of the day, and all five RBI for the Jabs as they'll take the lead here on the three-run shot off of Landon Yorick. That ball was hit hard. I didn't think it was going to leave the park the way it left the bat, but it did. And now the T-Birds trail it again, 5-3.
Now batting second baseman number 7, Frainer Chavez.
So Frainer Chavez will come to the plate. And he'll swing at the first pitch, foul it off. And it's an 0-1 count. Bases are clear now after the home run, of course. And Chavez will step back in, a 1-1 count here. And this ball hit hard. It is moving quickly over towards scoreboard and off of that scoreboard. And another home run. Third home run given up by Yorick in his 2 2/3 so far. And it's a 6-3 Midland College lead. But this is the type of day where the ball will fly out of the park quite a bit. And quickly, Mike Robbins is out. And he's going to make a move to the pen. So that'll do it for Yorick. He gives up 5 hits. And 2 2/3, 3 home runs though, and 6 runs, all of them earned. So Yorick will come off to a nice ovation from the T-Bird crowd here, and it would appear coming in. here for the T-Birds will be, is that Coppinger? I believe it is. It will be Paul Coppinger, the big man coming up. So we'll be back in just a few moments with the rest of this top half of the third. T-Birds trail at 6-3 to Midland College. All right, back here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field, where the T-Birds have seen their lead evaporate twice in the game so far. Had a 1-0 lead after one. Two-run shot by Parker in the second inning made it a 2-1 game. T-Birds come back up. Lorenzo Moresi with a two-run shot to make it 3-2 at the time. Then Parker comes back with a three-run shot of his own to make it 5-3. And then Chavez comes up and hits a bomb himself. And back-to-back Jacks have the Shaps ahead, 6-3 here. So the T-Birds have gone to the pen. They will bring in the big man, Paul Coppinger, 6'8 kid, who throws just about as hard as anybody I've seen in a while. 25 innings, is that correct, pitch this season? It is. This is his 13th appearance. He's started three, went 2-1. 34 hits given up, 27 runs, 26 of them earned, 8 walks, 36 strikeouts, a 12.96 K per 9 ratio, and a, is that correct, a 9.36 ERA. Doesn't seem that way, but then again, in this league, all things are possible. This ball is fouled back on the first pitch to Rumfield, Justin Rumfield. We'll face the 0-1 here. Rumfield on the season's hitting 390 as that one will bounce. It'll be a 1-1 count after the pitch from Coppinger. And we'll get a look at it again. So, Rumfield at 390, slugging 627, has 5 home runs, 33 batted in on the year. He's struck out 24 times, walked 9. Likes to swing the bat. He does again. He'll miss that time. 1-2. From Paul Coppinger. And we'll see what he does here. Two outs here in the third, and that one is fouled back as well. T-Birds looking to get back into the batter's box and swing the sticks a little bit, down at 6-3 here. This ball is hit hard but foul down the left side, and we'll have another look at it. 1-2 will remain the count. So, Rumfield back in there. I said Rumsfield. It's Rumfield. And he'll look at that one. It's called a ball, 2-2 count. -10 is Midland College here, 24-8 in conference play. This ball hit over to Iredale at short. He's up with it. Fires across. Gonzalez will catch it, squeeze it, and tag the bag. T-Birds are out of the inning, but they give up 4, and they now trail it 6-3 heading to the bottom half of the third. We'll be right back. Yeah. back again here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field. We just mentioned 40-10 on the season is Midland College. Your Thunderbirds, well, 40-11. Not much difference there. They're 27-5 in conference play. A three-game lead, as we said, over Midland College in this final weekend of the regular season. And I'm just looking at the stats here. These teams both really good. Midland scored 455 in their 50 games. Your Thunderbirds, well, they have scored 510 in 51 games. 360 average for the T-Birds, 352 team batting average for the Shaps. On base percentage, 463 New Mexico, 459 Midland. Slugging, T-Birds slugging 656, 582 for Midland. And in home runs, 93 by your Thunderbirds. Not counting the one we saw earlier from Lorenzo Moresi, so that'd be 94. And three today will make 59 for the Shaps on the season. So Josh Pearl will get to come to the plate here for the T-Birds against Boudreaux, Tyler Boudreaux. Pearl on the year, a 339 hitter, and looks at the first pitch for a ball. The sophomore in 109 ABs has 37 hits, 24 runs scored. He's got a home run on the season as well. But gets on base pretty often. That one a called strike, leaving up the count 2-2. Is that correct? Or is it 2-1? I thought it was 2-2. So here comes 2-1. Now it's 2-2. There you go. That's that one right down the pike that time. Let's see here. We might get some stats on Boudreaux, as he'll miss with that one and run the count full here with nobody out. Bottom half of the third inning, T-Birds trail at 6-3 to Midland. And the most important series of the season, of course, right at the end, you're playing the team that trails you by three games and you trail them by three runs. Walk issued to Pearl to start off inning number three for the T-Birds. And that will bring up J.D. Moreno. Moreno on the year has hit the ball pretty well. Not as well as he'd like. He hits it hard. Just seems like it's right at people. 318 average on the season. A 500 slugger. 424 OBP. On base percentage. First pitch across for a strike from Boudreaux to Moreno. And with 0-1 and a runner at first, nobody's out here for the T-Birds. Moreno's got this one. Will it fall? It does, just past a diving Martinez out and left. And T-Birds have runners at first and second with nobody out for Lorenzo Moresi. Moresi with a home run and two RBI in his last AB. The two-run shot giving T-Birds the lead back at 3-1 before they relinquished it in the top half of inning number three. So Moresi now will dig in. Boudreaux will look. The righty brings it. And Moresi looking for the fence again. Swings through that one, and it's 0-1. And the 0-1 on its way. Moresi lets that one go. It's called a ball and evens up the count at a ball and a strike. Boudreaux on the year. Let's see what he has done. 13 starts. He is 12 starts, 13 appearances, 11-1 on the year. Six complete games this season as well. That one catches the plate and it'll be a 1-2 count. Boudreaux has a 2.94 ERA and 67 and a third before coming in here today. You're not going to see very many much better than that gentleman in this conference. And this one will miss low this time from Boudreaux. Make it 2-2. Runners at first and second. Nobody out. We're in the bottom half of the third inning in a three-run game. The T-Birds, well, they trail. So Boudreaux will come to the plate with the 2-2. It's foul tipped and dropped by the catcher behind the plate. And so, staying alive with a 2-2 count is Lorenzo Moresi. One of a couple of Italian kids on the T-Bird roster, Stanley Tucci being the other. Did I say Stanley Tucci? Oscar Tucci. See, I'm reading too much into this. I said an actor and not the actual player, so sorry, Oscar, about that one. That one up high this time for a ball, and it's a 3-2 count. So, again, Parker with two home runs on the day for Midland College, and we're just in the third inning, has 10 on the year now. And the payoff pitch coming, fouled off by Moresi. And he'll stay alive and get another look. These two teams have been rivals for a while anyways. I mean, both teams usually very solid in WJCAC play. And it comes down to it, and that's the second time that the pitch clock has run out on Boudreaux in the game, and that'll be a ball four issued, if you will, to Moresi. And so the bases are loaded now for, well, this gentleman, Dylan Hasso. Hasso on the year has just done everything, it seems like. 448 hitter, slugging at 925, a 575 on base percentage. He has how many? 78 hits and 174 ABs, and has scored 71 times this season, 21 home runs on the year. First pitch from Boudreaux will catch the plate for a strike, and Hasso will take a step back and back in the box. 0-1. Nobody out. Bases are loaded here. T-Birds trail it by three. Boudreaux again taking his time, but coming to the plate in time this time. They'll call that one a strike. Looked like it was off the plate. And again, T-Bird fans kind of griping. Don't feel like they're getting those calls when their team is on the mound. So Dylan will foul this one back as it comes right down the middle, and he'll stay alive. 0-2, Brent Iredell on deck for your Thunderbirds. And Tyler Boudreaux will look in. And he'll deliver. Fouled off again by Hasso. And they'll do it again. So 0-2 to Dylan Hasso. Again, we're in the bottom half of the third inning. T-Birds trail Midland College 6-3. Midland College trails the T-Birds by three games in the conference standings, and this is the first of four to end the season. And so we'll go again. Another foul ball. Let me get into some of the national stuff here for the NJCAA. Swing and a miss, and Hasso has been retired on strikes as Boudreaux will get the K there. Here comes Iredell, has been retired on strikes earlier, his last AB, as a matter of fact. See if we can get some stats in here and see where we're at nationally, and I will get those rankings to you as we continue to go here. First pitch to Iredell, a called strike, and Iredell again not liking that one. Iredell himself with a little pop in that bat. As this one will miss from Boudreaux and make it a 1-1 count. Let's see, where's Brent at? Oh, God. Yeah. .435 average for the young man on the year, .525 OBP, and .857 slugging. This one's going to get down for a base knock. It will score one. Now there's a throw coming in. Looked like center fielder just lost that one trying to get it in here. The pitcher will cut it off. Two runs come across as both Pearl and Moreno score. And that makes it a 6-5 game now. And leaving his pitcher in and nobody out in the bullpen is head coach Hector Rodriguez. He is assisted by Brady Roper and Sean Griebeck. DAD Forrest Allen and President Steve Thomas of the school over at Midland College. As Aaron Lugo will step back in, Lugo hitting himself a healthy little average of .392 on the year. He has scored 77 runs this season. There's a throw over to first, trying to keep the gentleman honest. As Iredale, after his two-run single, brings the T-Birds to within a run here. One away, runners at the corners, and the wind really picking up now. More out towards center, maybe right center here. That pitch will miss here, and you can see a little dust flying across the field, even though it's turf here. Typical day in southeastern New Mexico. And another throw over to first. Iredale back again. And a 1-0 count here to Aaron Lugo. T-Birds have been hit a lot by pitches this year. It looks like 93 times they've been hit. Conversely, they have hit 48. Three times today already in this one, so 96 times they've been hit. They've doubled up their opposition. That one he called strike, and it's a 1-1 count. Lugo himself has been hit several times. Let's look. 11 on the year. Hasso 14. 19, though, from Jesse Herrera on the year. Leads T-Birds. Not sure that's the category you want to lead in, but he does. 2-1 count. And we'll see what comes here. Boudreaux still working pretty slowly and deliberately here on the bump. Going is Iredale, and it's going to be fouled off this time by Lugo. 2-2. So Lugo will step back in, looking to tie the game. A good deep fly ball or a base hit should do the trick with a runner at third. Also, Iredale over at first. This could be pitch coming there. It's going to be a called strike three. Lugo did not argue, so he agreed with that one. And that will bring up Eric Baenia, hoping that he lives up to Luke Fay's nickname of Eric Good Baenia here. T-Birds would love to see a three-run jack. So as Baenia steps in, I think he's had a pretty solid year. He came on late in the year, started off season not at his best. But he gets one out into center. Is it going to get past him? Yes, it'll get past the center fielder and bounce over the wall for a ground rule double. But it will tie the game as Lorenzo Moresi will come across and make it 6-all. Three runs across for the T-Birds. There's two outs and runners at second and third now for Mark Henning. Henning hitting .354. And looking to keep that going. I think Mark's only got the one home run on the year. He's got 29 driven in, though. And Boudreaux will deliver, and Henning will foul this off towards the left side and out of play. And it'll be an 0-1 count. So Baenia over at second after the ground rule double ties the game. And up high with that one is Boudreaux. 2-1. Or is that 1-1? That's right. That's 1-1. Excuse me. reading too much as I try to commentate on this game. You know, it's going to be the last day I get to talk to some of you folks out there. Some of you are probably happy about that. That pitch will miss too, and it is now a 2-1 count. I've enjoyed every bit of it this season. Kind of refreshed after last season, honestly, as an announcer. Foul tipped into the mitt that time, and it's 2-2. So Hiddings get the 2-2 count. Runners at second and third in a tie game. We're in the bottom half of the third, and it's 6-6. Three home runs by the Shaps in the game, two by Hudson Parker. Lorenzo Moresi with a shot for the T-Birds. Henning will foul this one back off to the left. So another look at a 2-2 coming here for Mark Henning. Now again, six complete games on the year for this 11-1 pitcher in his 12 starts, as Boudreau will get ready to go. Sub-3 ERA on the year. And he'll get a swing and a miss that time from Henning. And that'll do it for the T-Birds, but not before they tie it up. We head to the fourth, tied at 6. We'll be back. Back again here at the Ray. That's what I call it anyways. Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field. I'm Dusty Windham. Thanks for being here again with us. Whether you're here in town or in New Mexico, perhaps in the U.S. or somewhere else in this great big world of ours. We're happy to have you here with us. It's a service of New Mexico Junior College. They provide for friends and family of these athletes from, well, places far away, where people can't just get here and see the games all the time. They still have a way to keep connected to their student athlete here on campus. And man, am I glad they do, because it provides me something to do on these Friday afternoons. Been doing this now. This is my 29th season calling, well, sports on the radio. About the seventh in a row now here at New Mexico Junior College. Of course, been here before, many years ago. But just keeps getting better and better out here at New Mexico Junior College. And I can't thank the school enough for giving me the opportunity to come, watch games for free, if you will. Love to come out and watch and support these student athletes. Paul Coppinger on the mound here. Starts off this AB to Michael Widener with a strike, 0-1 count. And that one will miss outside for a ball, and it's 1-1 count. Now this one is popped back. And it's 1-2 count. Widener will step back in. And this time he hits his ball hard. It's out towards center. Moreno will back up and catch it in front of the warning track for an out. And that'll make it a one-out inning. Top half of the fourth, tied at 6. Midland College had a good lead after the third inning ended at 6-3. T-Birds do get three in the bottom half of the third to tie it up. And coming to the plate is going to be Kyle Lewis. This ball's hit right at Iredell. One hop into his glove. He'll get it across in time for the out. And there's two away.
With two outs, that brings up the shortstop, number 3, Cody Grabeck.
So the shortstop and leadoff hitter, Cody Grabeck, heading to the plate. And the first pitch will miss for a ball. Austin Mefford, head coach, women's basketball team here at New Mexico Junior College, making his appearance. That ball fouled back, by the way, to even out the count at a ball and a strike. And Coppinger comes to the dish this time. Going to be just off the plate outside to Grabeck, and it's 2-1. Coppinger's 2-1 is hit hard but fouled down the first baseline. Grabbed over there by Gonzalez. Tossed back over to Coppinger, and we'll get another look. 2-2 count. Two away here, and T-Birds looking for just their second scoreless inning defensively in this ball game. My hands got a little quick there. Too bad you guys couldn't see that on camera, huh? Best catch I've made in 9 years. Wind really kicking up again. The 2-2 swung on and hit hard out towards right. Looks like it's going to leave the ballpark, and it does. Fourth home run of the day for Midland College. And it's a 7-6 game. Chaps getting this one from Grabeck, the leadoff man, and that makes it a one-run game here. Still two outs, though, here in the top half of the fourth, as Jake Martinez will step back to the plate. It's one of those days here where, I've seen plenty of them, where the wind's going to blow like this all day, and you're just going to see a lot of balls fly out of the park, it would appear. This one to Iredale on the first pitch. And he'll get it across to Gonzalez to end the inning. 7-6, though, after the solo shot. And the T-Birds will take to the batter's box when we come back. So back here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field on the campus of New Mexico Junior College, I'm Dusty Windham. T-Birds, well, it's been a seesaw affair against these Midland College Chefs so far. We're in the bottom half of the fourth. T-Birds led it 1-0 after one. They led it 3-2 after two. They trailed, or actually it was tied 6-6 after three, and now it's a 7-6 Midland College lead as Boudreaux goes to work. Luis Gonzalez with a knock straight into center field, picked up on a hop and thrown back in. And that will bring up for your Thunderbirds the left-handed hitting Josh Pearl. And JP will step up with a chance here. Nobody out and a runner on. And this game has just been, well, what you expected. Boudreaux catches the outside part of the plate with his first pitch, and it's a strike called to Pearl. 0-1. The first baseman at first base, Luis Gonzalez over there. Pearl swings through that one as it kind of took a dip on him there. Just a bit of a drop. And it's 0-2. Boudreaux, again, has had a great year. six complete games, a sub-3 ERA, which surely is going up after this one, but he'll miss with that one, and it's a 1-2 count. J.D. Moreno standing on deck for the T-Birds. And the 1-2 is hit out into center, carrying a bit. Is it going to go? It does. Pearl over the center field wall on sophomore recognition day and graduation day at that. And he has given the T-Birds the lead back at 8-7. This is the type of baseball you expect here. On a day where the wind's blowing straight out the center, this is nothing new if you've been here before. Pearl now into the celebration. Will hit the ground on the big celebration as J.D. Moreno will step in and look to add to the hit total. 9 now for the T-Birds in the game. And again, the wind really blowing. And just almost straight away. This one will be off the plate outside this time for a ball from Boudreaux. And Moreno starts this with a 1-0 advantage. Lorenzo Maresi on deck for the T-Birds as Moreno gets one. This one's not staying in the park. Back-to-back jacks, and it is now 9-7 New Mexico Junior College. Both teams hitting the ball a ton today, and well, we're just in the fourth inning again. 9-7 T-Birds. Let's see, they've gotten home runs from Maresi and Moreno now, and also from Josh Pearl. Four hit on the other side that I could think of. Let's see, two for Parker, one for Chavez, and then the last one there a few moments ago in the top half of the inning, and now it's 9-7. So it looks like we're going to have a visit to the mound here for Midland College. We'll take a quick break, and we'll be right back. All right, after a visit to the mound here for the Chaparrales, you're going to have Lorenzo Maresi step to the plate. There's been back-to-back home runs in the inning. There's one away. We're in the bottom half of the fourth. T-Birds have regained the lead at 9-7. Boudreaux stays in after the visit, and this one's fouled back. And behind us here, didn't hit the roof, no big bang again. I'm a little disappointed in the amount of big bangs we've had this year. The 0-2 tipped back this time by Maresi, a quick fastball up a little bit. And it's fouled back. Hasso on deck is out to grab it. There's nobody out, is that right? Yeah, nobody out here in the fourth. Yeah, no, there's one. And a 1-2 count. So, maybe not. I do know the leadoff man got out. I thought we had it out, but I'll double check it. That one will miss. It's 2-2. Here goes Boudreaux to the plate, way inside. Sliding out of the way somehow is Lorenzo Maresi. That would have been the fourth hit batsman of the game for Boudreaux. Would have been, but nobody hurt on that one. Count now full at 3-2. And this one's going to be up high, and it'll be a walk issued to Maresi. Dylan Hasso now will come to the dish. So Hasso coming to the plate again, 448 coming into the weekend. 21 home runs was good enough for sixth as we ended a broadcast last weekend in the country. T-Birds adding to that run total on the season as Hasso will foul that one away, and it's 0-1. Finally, some action heading out to the bullpen for the Midland College squad. 9-7 game. T-Birds lead it here in the bottom half of inning number four. Runner at first and showing nobody out. As this ball is hit right up the middle, of one hopper to center field again. And a quick throw back into second to keep Moresi there. Hasso with a base knock. That will send to the plate Brent Iredell once again. Runners at first and second. So Iredell, first pitch way outside this time from Boudreau, and it is going to be a 1-0 count. 11 hits for the T-Birds, 9 runs so far in the game. And again, Boudreau on the year had not given up much at all. A 2.94 ERA coming into the game. Just outstanding for this conference, especially. That one across for a strike against 1-1. And we'll look at a 1-1 coming here. Runners at first and second here for the T-Birds and nobody out. Swing and a miss that time from Iredell, and it's 1-2. And we'll try it again. Brent Iredell at the plate. Runners at first and second. Nobody out with Aaron Lugo on deck for the T-Birds. Iredell's going to get this one out. And it is caught out and left on a dead run by Martinez. So there's an out now. And runners at first and second. So Lugo will step in here, looking to extend the inning, of course. Stay away from that ground ball double play, the pitcher's best friend, as Boudreau delivers a strike with his first one. Little furry companion here at the ballpark today. Strike called there as well. Looked outside from where I sit, but that's why I'm up here, not down there. And we'll see here what happens next. Paul Coppinger's on in relief of Landon York for the T-Birds. He's given up just the one run, a solo home run in the top half of this inning. Foul tip into the glove, and Lugo will go down. I don't think he liked those first two pitch calls. They were both a bit outside perhaps, or right on that corner, but not where Aaron liked them. And with two outs, Eric Bayania will step to the plate. Bayania has had a really strong conference season here for the T-Birds offensively. First pitch called strike there, and it's 0-1. You know, again, he started off season a little slowly. Coach said that he worked hard to earn his spot back in the lineup, and he has done so. To the plate this time, and missing on the pitch was Boudreau, and it's 1-1. Eric. Swing and a miss that time from Bionio. Run the count to one ball and two strikes here with two down and two on. Bottom half of inning number four. T-Birds up 9-7. And it'll be Mark Henning on deck should Bionio reach. Two arms in the bullpen, a righty and a lefty, it looks like, for Midland College. I couldn't see the numbers. That one way up high, and it's going to be a 2-2 count. Good crowd here on hand for Friday afternoon baseball. The 2-2 on its way from Boudreaux, swung on and missed, another strikeout for him, and Bionia goes down swinging. But T-Birds get a couple of jacks in the inning to regain the lead 9-7 over Midland College. We'll be back in just a few moments for the top half of inning number five. Back here for inning number five. T-Birds leading over Midland College. It is now 9-7 here. T-Birds with that two-run lead. It has been a back-and-forth affair, something you somewhat expect here in this conference and in this, what we call the league here. But it has been really tough at times for the T-Birds to get going. But not so much today, as Midland's providing all the inspiration they need here. 1-0 count as Coppinger misses with his first pitch here of the fifth inning. It's Rhett Clark back up, and he'll take a strike that time and make it a 1-1 count. So Coppinger will look back in. The big 6'8" T-Bird delivers. This one's fouled off the left side, off the clubhouse, and it's 1-2. Good to see a lot of the parents here in the stands today, those that can make it for sophomore appreciation. We appreciate them here, and I appreciate those of you out there still watching. The 1-2 swung on and missed, and down goes Clark. One away here now in the top half of inning number five. And for the Shaps, that will bring up Melendez. So Melendez will head towards the batter's box on the right side. Well, the right-handed hitting side, we'll say, the righty side. T-Birds with a couple arms up and getting loose out in the bullpen as well, as Coppinger deals a curveball there. It's right down the middle and called a ball. Mm. 1-0 count. pitch, a ball called as well, and I'm as incredulous as the people in the stands. Don't understand where those pitches are, but 2-0 count. This ball hit hard right at Iredale. He drives to backhand it on the slide. It'll get past him, and that'll be a one-out base hit for Midland College. That'll bring up Parker again. Two home runs in the game for this gentleman.
Number 8, Hudson.
5 batted in, and Commager will try to retire the young man. Runner on first and one away here. Top half of inning number 5 again. T-Birds lead it 9-7, but very dangerous hitter at the plate. Coppinger deals. It'll hit the ground, get through the wickets that time of Moresi, and taking second base will be Melendez. 1-0 count as heading back to the bump is Coppinger. So the wind's still blowing. I'm in the stand, so I can't feel it as bad, but that flag's staying pretty straight out in center field, blowing out towards straightaway center as a strike comes across from Coppinger. Chavez on deck here for the Shaps. The 1-1, a called strike, and it's 1-2. So Coppinger strike away from the second out of the inning here. And he gets it, swinging a miss that time, and Parker will head back to the dugout. So Chavez will come up to the plate. And he'll take his hacks against Coppinger here. First time he's faced him, same as Parker a moment ago. As I think Chavez was the last batter that Landon York faced in the game. Second of back-to-back jacks with Parker back in that third inning. This one, a good pitch called a ball, and T-Bird fans all over the blue behind the plate. So 2-0 count. This one's hit over at Iredale. He'll grab it and go to third. He'll get the out at third on the tag from Hasso. And the T-Birds have held the Shap scoreless for the first time since the first inning today. And they'll head to the bottom of the fifth with a 2-run lead. It's 9-7 here at New Mexico Junior College. We'll be back. All right, back here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field on the campus of New Mexico Junior College. I'm Dusty Windham. Thanks for being here with us again, folks. We are having a heck of a game. This is what you expect between these two. Top two in the conference. T-Birds lead it by 3 games over Midland and lead this game here that could clinch it with a T-Bird win. Clinch the conference title. They lead it 9-7. We're in the top half of the fifth. This game scheduled for 7 innings. Of course, you know how that works in JUCO ball. Every now and then, that game's tied after 7. That becomes the 9-inning game at that point. Should it stay at a 7-inning game here, we'll have game 2, 9-inning affair. About a half hour after this one finishes, as that one's fouled back. Boudreaux still on the bump here for Midland College. I would like to know what his pitch count is at this point. He's been in there a while, but again, he's thrown 6 complete games, 11-1 record with a 2.94 ERA on the year. It just got a little bit bigger. Mark Henning hits this one darn near straightaway center, over 400 feet, and the T-Birds now have a 10-7 lead. T-Birds have scored in every inning thus far. We're in the bottom half of the fifth. I said the top of the fifth a minute ago. I don't know what I was thinking. It's the bottom of the fifth. But Mark Henning getting into one there, and big celebration at the dugout for the T-Birds as Dylan Hasso Luis Gonzalez, followed by Josh Pearl. But the T-Birds getting to him a little bit, and we're finally going to have a pitching change as Boudreaux gives up 10 and his, four complete innings yet to get it out here in the fifth. And we'll have information on your new pitcher for Midland College when we come back. So, new pitcher for Midland College, as we welcome you back to the broadcast here, is Matt Guthmiller. Guthmiller from Omaha, Nebraska, a 6-foot freshman, lefty. Going to come in, try to give the T-Birds a different look, as going yard to lead off the inning was Mark Henning, giving the T-Birds a 10-7 lead, just a 3-run lead. You know, Landon York started this game for New Mexico Junior College on the mound and was pulled in a 6-2 game at the time. The T-Birds did tie, or 6-3 game at the time. They tied it up in the bottom half of the third inning, did the T-Birds, and Coppinger has come in and effectively done everything that you could ask of him. He's given up one run on a solo home run. That one coming back in inning number 4. We're in the bottom half of inning number 5, looking for 6 and 7 to get by quickly. Some of these kids are. It's graduation day here at New Mexico Junior College. Want to congratulate all the young men graduating, of course, and all the student athletes across New Mexico Junior College's amazing athletic programs here, headed up by Darren Clark, the athletic director. Sports information director is Luke Fay. First year I've ever had one of those, and I'm so grateful, folks. So Gonzalez will be the first to face Guthmiller. First pitch going to be up a bit and a called ball. It's a 1-0 count. Let's see what Guthmiller's time. 36 1/3 thrown, and that one will go off the mask that time. 2-0 count. So Guthmiller on the season, let me find him again. There he is, 16. This will make 17 appearances for him. He started 6, he's 2-1, has a save on the year. And Gonzalez will pop it up just outside of the infield, and it will get caught somehow by Melendez, and now they're going to say, no, he's in safe. Gonzalez back to the bag, thought he was out, but the ball was dropped by Melendez. And I think we're going to have all kinds of conversation out here. The umpire talking now with Duff Miller. Gonzalez thought he was out. Heck, everybody in the stands thought he was out. Ball goes away from Melendez and is picked up and thrown back to first. But luckily for the T-Birds, Gonzalez was in there safely. And now we have a runner at first due to the T-Birds with Josh Pearl at the plate. Pearl got him a good shot earlier. He swings and misses on that pitch and it's 0-1. So Gluth Miller is 36 and a third. He's given up 44 hits, 29 runs, 28 of them earned coming in. He'll miss with the ball that time, evening the count at 1-1. He has a 9.91 K per 9 ratio. He's given up 10 home runs on the year, most on the Midland College squad. But has a 6.94 ERA, 16 walks, 40 strikeouts on the year. Swing and a miss by Pearl that time, and it's 1-2. Nobody out, and Luis Gonzalez over at first base for the T-Birds. Standing on deck, J.D. Moreno, another young man who's got a home run today and deserved it. He's been hitting the ball really well, just a lot of times right at somebody. He's been getting solid contact on it. Down on strikes is Josh Pearl that time for the first out of the inning, and that will bring up Moreno with Lorenzo Maresi, another gentleman with a home run today, coming to the plate. Oh, well, he's on deck. He may come to the plate. We'll see. Avoiding the double play here. JD on the year. Watches that first pitch come by for a ball. But Mr. Moreno with 42 hits and 132 ABs coming into today. He had that was his third home run of the season. 35 batted in now. Struck out 23 times, 18 walks. That one will miss as well from Guth Miller. And it is going to be a 2-0 count. Yeah, should Maresi get back up? He's been hitting pretty well at a 362 clip himself. And he's got, is that correct? 7 home runs, 8 now on the year. Strike called that time on the 2-0 on the outside part of the plate. And that's what it'll be as he steps back up on the bump. Guth Miller, the lefty, going against the left-handed hitting Moreno. T-Birds lead it 10-7 here in the bottom half of the fifth. And Guth Miller will throw over towards first. Low, but handled by Melendez. This one off the plate outside, and now a 3-1 count to J.D. Moreno. Dad in the stands, I see today. Or saw him earlier. Yeah, there he is. I see him still. He's still at the park here. He's always here. 3-1 count. That one is a strike called. Looked like a good pitch from here. Looked like it crossed the plate. J.D. thought it might have been ball four, but it was not. So payoff pitch coming here with a runner at first and one away for the T-Birds, who have scored on the Mark Henning home run in the inning to extend their lead to 3-10-7. Runner goes, and they'll call a strike three. Gonzalez will get to second. The ball will bounce out into center field. I thought that was a bad call by the plate umpire, but it'll stand. And there's two down. That ball was way high. So Maresi will step back up, this time hitting from the right side, the switch hitter. With a runner at third, as Gonzalez looks tired over at third base. He was expecting to take one bag, not two. That's first pitch strike. Maresi looks back like he didn't like the call. But it's an 0-1 count, two down. And Guth Miller gets that one by him. It's tipped by Maresi, and 0-2. That ball looked like it may have trailed outside there, but swung on and tipped into the mitt. And it's 0-2. Two down with a runner at third for the T-Birds. Bottom half of the fifth. Guth Miller Sees that one fouled back again. And Moresi will stay alive for another pitch. Again, these two teams, 40-10 for the Midland College Chaparrals, 40-11 for your Thunderbirds on the year, just almost identical. T-Birds do hit with a little more power, it would seem. The numbers say so anyways. This ball hit hard right at third base. He's up with it and gets it across. And so that will end the inning for the T-Birds, but not before they score again. It's 10-7 heading to the sixth. We'll be right back. T-Birds back up 10-7 in this back and forth affair between themselves and the Midland College Chaps. Chaps come in three games behind the T-Birds in conference standings with four games to go. That means if T-Birds win this one, they'll be up by four with three games to go and win the conference. That's how that math works. I didn't know if everybody out there knew that, but they do. So it's still Coppinger on the bump for the T-Birds, looking at some stats across. Number 12 and 13 in the nation in batting average. Well, they belong to the Chaps and the T-Birds. Number 12 is Melendez, the first baseman, who is hitting at 449. And Hasso, Dylan Hasso, the third baseman for the T-Birds, hitting at 448 on the year. Brent Iredale, by the way, 23rd in the country with his average of 435. Just a really good season for these T-Birds. And, of course, everybody in this conference, one of the toughest in the country, no doubt. And just doesn't get any easier. It seems like both these teams are going to be heading to regionals, obviously, and they'll be taking on some really good squads on the other side of this Region 5 bracket. And could see some real competition. Ranger College has a kid hitting 482 in Bautista as well. So Rumfield will come to the plate here. Justin Rumfield for Midland. And the first pitch called a ball again. And I just disagree with it, but call me a homer, call me what you will. It's been pretty one-sided on the strike zone today. This one fouled back. And it's a 1-1 count. I mean, just pitches that look like right down the middle being called balls, and then pitches foot outside being called strikes against the T-Birds. I don't know. That's just my personal opinion, though. Now this ball is hit, and just off the end of the bat, it'll get it out into right field. Will Rumfield. Looked like he was out at first. That was a close call. I'm not sure the field umpire was ready for that one. And that's probably what happened. It looked like they had him by about 8 or 10 inches there, diving back into first. But Rumfield got back in, and that will bring up Widener, Michael Widener. He swings at the first pitch, hits it at Lugo, over to Iredale at short. Double play turn there by the T-Birds, much to the delight of the home crowd. And there's two away quickly. That'll bring the shortstop, Cody Grebeck, back to the plate. Oh, no, it's not. It's going to be Lewis first, then Grebeck. Excuse me. Forgot about Kyle Lewis, center fielder. 336 hitter is Lewis. 6 home runs, 28 RBI. And he'll swing at the first pitch from Coppinger. He hits it pretty far out into that left center field gap. Moreno over to make the catch, and the T-Birds have two straight scoreless innings against the Chaps. And now they're three outs away from the conference championship. But before that, they've got a chance to hit. We'll be right back. 10-7 T-Birds heading to the bottom half of the sixth. All right, back at Rick. Just kidding. We're in the bottom half of the sixth. T-Birds would like to skip ahead and see if they can't get three outs and win this conference title, but they cannot do that without swinging the bats first. And Gus Miller, on in relief of Boudreaux for the Shaps, will face, first off, Dylan Hasso. Hasso 13th in the country, as we said, in batting average. Let's go look at these home run totals, see if I can get where he sits nationally at the moment. As a, you know, little Wi-Fi out the ballpark never hurt. So let's look at home runs. I want to say 21 on the season for the young man, Dylan Hasso. He's tied for sixth in the country with those 21. Looking to get one here, move up a spot, which would put him alone in sixth place. As the weekend begins anyways. Swing and a miss by Hasso, and Guth Miller's ahead in the count 0-1. And Hasso right out into center, but right at Lewis, and the catch is made. One away for the T-Birds in the bottom half of the sixth now, as Iredell will head to the plate. Brent Iredell, believe it or not, actually tied for 30th in the country in home runs. And he'll face Guth Miller here. First pitch is swung on and fouled into the T-Bird dugout. Behind Mr. Iredell here, you will have Aaron Lugo to hit. See what we have in doubles this season. As that one is a check swing, say he didn't go around, 1-1 count. Lugo tied for fourth in the country in doubles for the T-Birds. Melendez in there at 13th in the country. Clark also in there for Midland College at 22nd. Dylan Hasso, 37th. And Martinez, Jake Martinez, at 37th as well. And that's just in doubles. So there's a ton of talent on the field out here today. A huge weekend for the T-Birds, both academically and athletically, as they have a chance to clinch the conference title with a win here today. Swing and a miss that time, and that will send down Iredell. I think that's the third time today he's gone down on strikes. But that will bring up Aaron Lugo. Guth Miller retires Iredell on strikes that time, and the young Aussie head is back to the dugout. As Lugo comes up, Eric Bionia would hit behind him should Lugo reach. First pitch swinging and fouling this one back and out of play is Lugo, 0-1 count. Let's see, in hitting on the year. As team stats, that one goes wide for a ball, 1-1 count. T-Birds are fourth in the country as a team with a 360 batting average. Midland ninth in the nation heading into the weekend anyway. So two of the top 10 hitting teams in the country doing battle right here. Lugo swings and misses on that one, and it's a 1-2 count. So will it be Coppinger back out on the mound for the T-Birds? I guess we'll see after this inning ends, or are they going to look to anyone else to close it? Swing and a miss. Oh, he gets a piece of it, I guess, and will stay alive. I didn't hear it that time. Sounded more like it hit the mitt. In home runs on the year. I know T-Birds are way up there. Let's get back to it. And Lugo will readjust his guard for his elbow on that left arm as he sets in the swing. And home runs, T-Birds fourth in the country with 93 coming into the weekend. This one fouled back. Big bang. Yep, there's the big bang. Luke Fay wasn't ready for it that time. He said no. That's like the fourth big bang of the year, but I'm excited to have one today, you see. 1-2 on its way, gonna miss a bit high perhaps that time on Lugo. Not the tallest kid on the field, I'll tell you that. 2-2. Still breezy here. Nice warm day though. Lugo gets into one. Puts it up. It's going to clear the left field wall and extend the T-Birds lead to four as Aaron Lugo now has made it 11-7 with the home run off of Matt Guthmiller. Wow, what a great shot for Aaron Lugo and a nice parting shot for the day for him. The sophomore in his final home stand at New Mexico Junior College. Really hate to hear that, but gets another one. I'm going to check on his RBI totals. I figure he's pretty high up. I think he leads the T-Birds and runs batted in. We're going to double check and see if we can find him on the list nationally. Yeah, he's 38th in the country coming into the weekend, but that another home run for Aaron Lugo, and it's 0-1 to Bayania as he'll step in with two outs here in the sixth. That one bounces from Guthmiller, and it'll be a 1-1 count. For Lugo, let me double check here and make sure I see it correctly. That was home run number, I believe, 9 on the year for him. Let's double check it. Yep, 10. Excuse me. Of course I'd be wrong. 1-2 pitch coming now from Guthmiller to Bayania. He calls a third strike, does the plate umpire on Bayania again. He'll just shake his head and walk back to the dugout. Game two today, that gentleman will be in the field, and I think the T-Birds will be happy to see that. 11-7 as we head to the top half of the seventh. It will be Paul Coppinger back out on the mound to try to clinch the conference championship for the T-Birds. 4-run lead heading in to the top half of the seventh. We'll be right back. The shortstop, Cody Graybeck, will start it off for this Midland College team here in the seventh as he'll step in to face Paul Coppinger. Coppinger will deal the first pitch. Called strike on the outside part of the plate. and an 0-1 count. T-Birds three outs away from winning the WJCAC Championship, Western Junior College Athletic Conference. Still an arm loose for the T-Birds in the bullpen, just in case. This one just off the plate outside that time. It's a 1-1 count. That's got to be the best nickname on the team. I'm not going to repeat it until I double check it, but I like that one. This ball hit hard down the right side. Going to hook foul, though, into the bullpen. Almost taking out a Shap pitcher out there who ducked his head and didn't find the ball there right away. Luckily, he was not hit with anything. And a 1-2 count here. Coppinger to Grebeck. Up high, and a ball called. Evens it up at 2-2. This one fouled off, and Grebeck will get another look here. So Coppinger digs in at the rubber on the mound here. And the 2-2 on its way up high, going to be a ball three and a full count. Don't know how short a leash he'll be on with Coach Robbins trying to clinch this conference championship here for New Mexico Junior College. This one's going to be poked out into center. It'll bounce once. Moreno's up with it, and we'll get it in quickly. Grebeck will stop at first, but the leadoff man on for the Chaparrals here. Shaps next will send to the plate. Of course, Jake Martinez.
Left fielder, number one, Jake Martinez.
Martinez stepping in here with a... Let's see what his average is. 345 on the year, and a ball called on the first pitch there. 1-0 count from Coppinger to Martinez. Martinez has 5 home runs, 40 runs batted in on the season, struck out 32 times, 27 walks on the year. And that's pretty solid. This one fouled right back up into the netting here behind home plate, and it's 1-1. The difference in these two teams is minimal, at least statistically on the season. 352 batting average for Midland coming in, 360 for the T-Birds, number 4 and 9 in the country. That one, a swing and a miss, and it's 1-2. Coppinger has given up just one run in his time in this ballgame. That one fouled back, and they'll get another look at a 1-2, excuse me. T-Birds had 93 home runs coming into this weekend's 4-game set against the Shaps. Well, they got 4 today. That's 97, just really hitting the ball well, especially when the wind's blowing like this. Swing and a miss, and the first out of inning number 7 comes via the strikeout. Jake Martinez goes down swinging. Coppinger with another one there. And Rhett Clark will come to the plate, the third baseman. With one away, his team trailing by 4, and it's a must-win game for them. The Shaps, as they look to keep pace with the T-Birds here, but the final series of the season, they trail by 3 games with 4 games to go if you count this one. T-Birds win this one mathematically. That does it for Midland. And your Thunderbirds will be the conference champions. Up high that time is Coppinger with the pitch, and runs count to 2-0. Paul looks down at the wristband that Coach Robbins has the pitchers wear here. That's how he calls the pitches from the dugout. This ball hit hard and to left. It's going to get down for a single and through the infield, of course. Iredell will pick up the throw from Bayania, and that'll put runners at first and second with one away for Melendez.
One out that brings up the first baseman, number 29, Xavier.
Nobody hurt.
Melendez.
Dangerous hitter here. Melendez with a really good season going. Again, he's in the in that higher echelon of statistical success here. So let's get back into the average. I know he was way up there. First pitch called strike there by Commodore, and it's a one count. There he is, 12th in the country, just a single percentage point ahead of. Oh, had a chance, did the T-Birds, to end it right there. They'll go off of Lugo and out into left field. It will score one run here. And I don't know that he had an error all year coming into that, but that one's going to be an E charge too. Lugo there, and it allows a run to score, 11-8 to score now. As Hudson Parker comes up, he's got two home runs in the game already. Five RBI on the day. And the wind is still kicking just a little out towards center field. Coppinger gets the first pitch across for a strike. Taylor made double play ball. Lugo looked at Coppinger, took the blame for it. He not happy with it, and probably harder on himself than anybody else will be at this point. And the 0-1 on its way. This one fouled back. Now Coppinger did strike out Parker his last time up, so he's hoping to have a repeat performance of that. And with an 0-2 count, he's well ahead. Runners at the corners. We're in the top half of the seventh inning and a game scheduled for seven. There's the strikeout again. It'll get Parker two home runs, but also two strikeouts today for the gentleman. So three strikes away now are the T-Birds from the Wag Jag title. As Frener Chavez will come up to the plate. Some of the fans on their feet here in the stands as Coppinger will look to try to get this third and final out. Close the book on the conference championship anyways, not the season. There will be three more games. One more today here. Lugo boots that one, gets it to Gonzalez just in time, and the T-Birds have won the WJCAC conference championship with that win over Midland College. We'll be back in about a half hour with yet some more T-Bird baseball as they'll take on the second place Chaps.